Paul Sirapusco here with FLIR Systems. Today we're going to be talking about our T-Series cameras. What we're going to show here is some of the measurement features of the T-Series cameras. In the menu structure, we can do what's called a single shot. You can record video, and you could actually even do a time-lapse video, and you can see here the interval. So let's say we want to set our camera up, maybe look at a motor control center, maybe look at a hot bushing or a process. You could ask the camera, hey, save an image every 20 seconds. Here in the settings, we can turn on compensation for looking through an IR window. So some of you folks out there that use IR windows to look inside maybe your motor control center or MCC buckets or your panels, this allows you to now compensate. You might want to compensate for temperature, but you also might want to compensate for the transmission of the window. Here we can go ahead and change the object distance. So when we set up and looking at outdoor targets, we can set up a distance. And this happens to be, I think I have my camera set up in feet, but it might be meters. But we can go ahead and set that up in terms of distance from the camera to the object. Now we're doing stuff indoors. We really don't need to set that. Also in the menus, we can change the atmospheric temperature. So if, again, we're doing a lot of outdoor work, long distance targets, these are some of the settings that you might want to use, along with humidity and along with reflected temperature. And of course, our setting for emissivity. So if you've gone through a lot of our ITC training or some type of infrared training, you know different targets emit differently in the infrared spectrum. So here we can set our emissivity value. As we move across, we can change the camera setting from our thermal MSX, and this is where you can actually see that visible image now, as we call, kind of raised or embossed on top of that thermal image. So some of the things that you could really point out is you could almost read all of the text on that fuse. Whereas if we turn off the MSX and just go to thermal, watch closely, you'll notice now it's actually disappeared. So again, this MSX is a really powerful feature that allows us to show the visible aspects of the image on top of the thermal. We could do picture in picture. Again, I talked a little bit about this, how it still kind of interferes with the image, but we do have it in there. You can use picture in picture. And of course, if you want to just go to the visible light camera, you can go ahead and turn that digital camera on. And as you can see, it is live. So you can record video or you can take a snapshot picture. As we move across our go back to thermal. We can then, of course, put some of our measurement modes on the screen itself. So starting with the left, we have no measurements. So let's say you had a bunch of measurements on the screen. We can get rid of all those with just one click of the button. So now let's say I want to add a spot. We're going to go ahead and hit spot, and you can see it's now brought up a center spot on the image, and it's now in the center. Nice thing about this touch screen is I can go ahead and select that. I'm going to go ahead and touch it, and I can move it anywhere on the image that I'd like. Now I can put it on, let's say, this fuse. So we're reading a temperature here of 82.8 degrees Fahrenheit. So as we move across our measurement functions, we can go ahead and you can see here we have a couple different options. You see one is red, one is blue. So what red is going to give us is this area or region of interest, and now you can see there's four right angles on the screen with a red pixel, or should I say a red center spot that's moving around. Well, the nice thing about this is that the measurement feature is doing all the work for you. If you notice, when I put the center spot on there, I had to move it and maybe take a guess as to where the hot spot is. Well, the camera's doing it for you. Of course, we can move this. So if we wanted to move the box, I'm just going to touch it and I can move it around the screen. Or if I wanted to actually make it a little bit bigger, I can grab one of the corners and we can then size that. So now we encompass a much larger area. And again, you'll see that spot. Go ahead and find the hottest pixel for us. Now, vice versa, if you wanted to do a cold spot, that's what the blue one is. So we can go ahead and hit cold, and you'll notice it now changed from red to blue. And you can see here the camera has actually located a measurement or something on a fuse that is about 70 degrees, which is actually a reflection. As you can see, as I move my hand around, you'll see that reflection coming off the copper, and I can change the temperature of that. Color palettes. I think I mentioned this when we were talking about some of the features of using your programmable keys. You can use what's called rainbow. Again, there's a bunch of in here, high contrast. You can go where white hot and black is cold. And of course, we can flip that around where black is hot and white is cold. So again, just some of the palettes that we've put into the camera system. This is what we call more or less our isotherm, right? So what we mean by isotherm, or you can see here, is labeled as a temperature limit. Now, what does this mean? So we can set the camera up, and what we can do is we can say anything above 95 degrees Fahrenheit, it will show up in a different color. So if we go ahead, let me just set this a little lower. I don't know, we'll set it to 80. And then what we could do is I really like to show this in white hot. Now, what do I mean by that? So when we come back out to the image, we don't see anything lighting up right now. But if I change that again, you can see here we're in a low, or what I can say, 88. If you look at the top of the image, you'll notice on the right-hand side, well, we're really only at 79 degrees Fahrenheit in this particular image. So nothing is showing up as red. So what I can do is I can change that scale just to kind of show where, if we try to really crank this down, and then I'm going to get rid of the measurement box, show none. Okay, everyone, let me go back here. I'm gonna lower the limit, right? So let's lower that. And you'll notice, and I want the background, you'll start to see the red come into the field of view. So I think that top limit was around 79 degrees. So let me go back out, go back to auto. So what we're showing here is everything in red that you see on the image is 76 degrees Fahrenheit or above. So really nice when you go into a target and you want to be able to say, hey, I want to see anything that's above a certain threshold. This allows us to go ahead and do that. So another nice feature built into the camera system. So if I go ahead and come in here, I'm gonna make sure I have a nice, of course, focused image. So what I have on our screen right now is I can preview the image before saving. So I'm gonna go ahead and preview that. Yes, it's a good image. And let me go ahead and store that. So in the camera, I set it up to store the visible and a thermal that you can see on the bottom. Now, if I want to go back and look at that, I'm going to go ahead and just press my play button, and you can see we're now going to access the images on our SD card. So let me go through my library and pull up the image that we just stored. So again, in the field, you can go ahead and capture this data, go back to your office and do analysis with software, or if you'd like, you can take this image and we can do some editing. So as when we touch the screen or use our enter key, you see a couple buttons on the side here. Now the one over here, this will go from the thermal to the visible, so you can kind of go back and forth. So let me go back to thermal, and I'm gonna click these three buttons on the side, and it gives us some tools. We can edit, we can throw it out. You can even touch the information button. You can see the date, the time, everything that we stored here in the camera system itself, okay? So now we could also do is we can add some of the tools that we just talked about. So let's say I wanted to record audio. You'll notice the microphone here on the far right. I'll go ahead and select the microphone. So you'll notice we now have a recording capability at the bottom of the screen. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'll click record, and you'll see the timer start counting down, and I can now talk to the image. I've got a fuse, it's hot on the left side, it's cooler on the right side. We should come in here, inspect, clean, and replace. Once I'm done, I'm gonna go ahead and hit stop. And now that voice annotation has been added to this image. So we will now be able to not only extract the thermal image, the visible image, but now we have a audio translation that we can take out of that. So another nice feature that we have in here, what we call those text comments. So as we kind of come down to the bottom of the screen here, you'll see this table. Now, I set up what I used as my electrical list. To be honest with you, one of my customers gave this to me a really long time ago and said, here, this is what I use when I store an image. So think about this. You're out there, you're taking an image, and maybe you've already set some presets in here. So I can come in and I have a battery room, a computer room, cooling towers, electrical, and there's a long list in here, and I can just scroll up and down. So let's just say you're at an area where you need to go ahead and take an image of a substation. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit substation, and now that's in my list. So what's the benefit of this? We could now store all of these, what we call text comments, or this list with that image. So let me go back. I've stored a thermal, I've stored a visible, I've stored an audio annotation, and now I've got this list. So when I pull all of this metadata back into my software, I don't have to go back and remember, where was I? What was the equipment I was looking at in a substation? Oh, I see. I have my list here that I can go through. It happened to be a circuit breaker in that substation. Well, as a qualified person in that field, I can maybe say, hey, you know what? It was a cracked insulator. And so some of the correction things that we can do here, clean, tighten. But let's say you have something else that you want to add. You'll notice when I pull these boxes up, at the top, there's a little keyboard. I can say, wait a minute, this isn't in my list. I can come in here and start typing, you know, major problem, space. And now when I go back, obviously if it was major, major, we want to have someone come in here right away. But now when I hit done, I've now got a brand new piece of information that I've stored in my text comments. And of course, when I'm done, I'm going to go ahead and hit save. Once again, all of that information is now saved with the image. With the camera, one of the nice things that we can focus in on is what we call this one-touch level and span. Right now, we're in the auto mode. So what's happening right now is the camera's looking at the image and it's saying anything below 69.8 and 77 degrees Fahrenheit, it's going to kind of continually optimize the image. That's why sometimes you'll see those change dynamically. So if I put my hand in front of it, you'll see the temperatures change very, very quickly. Well, with one touch level and span, I can really dial in some of the things I want to look at. So I'm going to click my button and go from auto to manual. Now, in manual mode, I could go ahead and select and change the upper limit. You could see the image change the contrast and level. I can change the bottom limit and you can see that change. But again, with this one touch level and span, what's really nice is I could touch anywhere on the image and you'll see the now the temperatures change dramatically. So you'll see the top now went to 76 to 72.4. Well, it happened really quick, but when I touch, you'll see a circle show up and that circle is giving us the indicator of what was in that circle, the amount of pixels, what was the high, what was the low. So if I go to that really hot part and I click it, you'll notice that image change. One touch level and span is really, really powerful tool that again, really highlights how you can, so to speak, dial in a really clean image. But if you don't like to use that, of course, you can go back to the auto mode and it will optimize the picture for you. Okay, so let's talk about some of the measurement features built into the camera system. So if we go back into our menu structure, we can see here under measurement, we've got a couple of actual presets. So if I kind of scroll to the right, you'll see user preset number one and user preset number two, which is a really nice feature because what you could do is instead of just maybe adding that one spot or box or, you know, hot spot or cold spot, you can still do that. But, you know, if you wanted to add more spots or more boxes, what we're going to do is we're going to go into our preset. And what's nice about this is you can save all of these functions. So when I boot my camera back up, I can go into my user preset and I might have, let's say, a box. And in that box, I want to have the maximum temperature. And maybe I want to use a spot as a reference temperature. It's quite often what we're going to be doing is referencing something in that area to contrast and see what that temperature differential or that delta T temperature is. So let's go through that. So if I go into my user preset, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down the button and you'll see the blue line kind of update. And now what we want to do is it's asking us, we can add a spot, we can add a box. And if you notice, now we even have a circle. So there's a couple of different things that you can add here. But for this demonstration, let's go ahead and add a box. And what I want to do is place this box over the fuses. So once again, everyone, you can select the box. I can change the size. So let's encompass both of the fuses in this hot target. And right now it's set to, as you notice, it's blue. So it's finding the coldest spot. So we got to go in and change that. So if we kind of come back in here, and what I want to do is you'll see if I go back into my measurements, it brings up a different menu. And you'll notice there's a blue line that's indicative of the cold spot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and click the red one, and now it's going to find the hottest pixel or maximum temperature within that defined area. Now another interesting thing while we're in here is you can notice the minimum is still on. You can actually compare and contrast the max or the min within that area. But for this, I'm going to shut off the minimum temperature. Let's just leave that maximum on there and kind of do a temperature differential there. So now that I'm done, I can go ahead and hit OK, and we have our box. So what I want to do now is I want to add a reference temperature. Now, generally, you can put another box. That's absolutely something that you can do. Or what we can do is I can add actually another spot. So what I mean is I'm going to take a temperature of this couple pixels versus the maximum temperature. So what's really nice about this to make your job quick is you can set that reference temperature, let's say off to the side that you might be looking at, or you can set it to something else in the field of view. But the nice thing is then we can then calculate that difference and say, oh, this hot spot is a certain degree over, or if it's reaching 50 degrees or something like that, we now know how quickly we can do our scan. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add a spot, and you can see it put it right up on the center, but let me move that spot, and I'm just gonna put it off here to the left of the image. Again, this is my reference temperature, but let's go one step further. So now that I'm completed with the spot, I've got my box, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add what's called the delta. So you notice it brings up a new menu. So what I wanna do is I wanna take the maximum temperature. So we're gonna do the box, the maximum or MX, and we're gonna subtract that from our reference temperature. Again, something in the field of view that we're referencing. Could be the background, could be another target, but now we can set that. And again, we're gonna subtract that. So now we'll have that calculation up on our screen. So when we do this, now you'll notice, let me go ahead and accept that. So we'll go ahead and say save. So you notice that's now saved. So what we're seeing on a screen here is your spot of 74.1 degrees. Our box maximum is about 111, and there's our delta measurement. Again, now it's doing it all for you. So once again, a really nice feature in a camera that allows us to get the information and get it quickly so we can get everything that we need to make those decisions.